You know, the programs like the Commission is putting in front are basically the political orientations, and these are a kind of policy design, but in reality you need bottom-up activities which change the world. So the platform is gathering the initiative, gathering ideas from bottom-up, bringing them together and helping delivering the political ambition which was drafted in the circular economy program in the Commission. First, you need to understand the concept why the circular economy is important. We are living in a totally different kind of world than we lived generation two ago. So we are seeing on one hand increasing population growth, increasing per capita consumption, shortage of resources, huge impact on environment and all the consequences. So I think nowadays the reasoning for circular economy, it's becoming more and more obvious, and in the companies, in particular in those companies who are thinking a bit long term and strategically, they are very well aware of that. But there is no single answer, so each one of the companies needs to find out their best possible ways how to address that question. It could be the business model, it could be just changing, for example, the people from whom you are buying, the resources, the materials and so on. Everything contributes to that, and when you put those things together and start thinking then in a more responsible way, which is at the same time when you talk about the use of the resources, also much more competitive way, then the things start to fall together. And I think many of the things are happening in the private sector, and I'm absolutely sure that many of the companies in the near future will be wholeheartedly going that way. Actually, we have adopted a lot of international agreements, yes, last year. One was Sustainable Development Goals, which are looking to the future till 2030. One was the Climate Change Agreement, which is again pointing with commitments till 2030. When we have reviewed our legislation about handling of the waste, again we set our targets to 2030. So a lot of the thinking nowadays is connected with this next 15 years and with the change of the economic model which is behind to get that kind of commitments. So I think the world is realizing pretty much straightforwardly that the way we have behaved in the production and consumption in the past will simply not lead us to a sustainable future. And that's why all those goals, all those commitments, I think, are bringing hopes, but hopes are not enough. Implementation is necessary. Main reasons are relatively simple. So we are locked in old traditional business structures, models, infrastructures, financial models. We are seeing increasing resource prices, at least from 1995 till 2009. The last years it was a bit of decline, but expectation is highly likely that the things will continue due to the pressure which is coming from the increase of population and also shortage of resources. We are also seeing that in many cases, in particular developed countries like Europe, are import dependent. These are all economic reasons why the change is necessary. Saying that, you will never have everybody for the change, because some are simply living from optimization of this moment, optimization of this structure, and the change would actually for them mean that they would have hard times to stay on the market. And that's why you will always have the skeptics, but I think for me the most important message which I think one has to understand is that the change is inevitable. Sooner or later it will happen. Better prepared you enter into that kind of change, better it's for you also from the business point of view. Simply, we want the platform, it's a great idea. Each great idea needs a good advisory board. We will try to steer it in the direction which will be most fruitful, and that's exactly how it works.